A very good morning, student. I hope you all are doing well. In yesterday video, we have already learned about a single linked list. Today we are going to see a single circular linked list, that is one of the type of linked list. As yesterday we have already seen a single linked list in which we have seen the types of operations performed on the single linked list. Insertion, deletion, merging, sorting, these are the certain operations we are going to perform on a single linked list. But there are some drawbacks of single linked list. So what are the drawbacks of single linked list? The drawback of single linked list is, once you have traversed the linked list and reaches to the last position, we cannot come again back, or we cannot visit the previous nodes. To overcome this drawback, the concept of single circular linked list is invented. So what is the basic fundamental idea used for to develop a single circular linked list? In single circular linked list, the last node point to the address of the first node. As given in this particular diagram, the very first node address is 120, having data value is 2. His link field consists of the address 230. Then we can visit the node having the address 230, visit the appropriate data value is 4. The address field is having the address 340. Then again we have to visit the node having the address 340. Again the data value is 6, we have to visit the data value 6. Again the address field is 120. It means that the last node pointing to the address of the first node. So 120 is the address of the very first node. It means that in a single circular linked list, we are going to traverse the whole linked list in a circular fashion. That's why that particular linked list is called as a single circular linked list. Again, there are certain operations will be performed on the single linked list, as we have already seen in the last video. Just will tell you, as we already know what are the different types of operations will be performed on a single linked list. The very first and a basic operation is insertion of the node, deletion of the node, merging of linked list, and sorting the data available at the linked list. The very first operation, insertion, again under the insertion operation we are having three cases: insert at the beginning, insert at the last position, and insert in between. For example, in this diagram, suppose if I want to insert one particular node at the beginning, so very first node which is having the address 120, suppose if you want to store or insert one particular node, for that you required to create one node, having some address is 200, put your data value in the information field, and the link field which consisting the address of 120. It means that it is the previous first node address of the linked list. It means that in the very last node consisting 120 address, so instead of 120, the last node will consisting the address which is newly inserted node, suppose the address is 200. In second case, suppose if you want to insert the node at the last position or at the ending position, it means that after the 6, or we can say if you want to insert the new node after the node which address is 340, that means the node which is having the address 340 is the last node. If you want to insert a node after this, it means that you want to create one particular node, you have to insert that node, add some data values in the data field, and in the address field you have to store the address of very first node. Suppose 120 is the address of very first node, you have to store the address in the newly constructed node. But in the previous node, whose data value is 6 or whose address is 340, whose link field is right now changed, instead of 120, you have to store the address of newly created node. This one is the second case. Similarly, for the third case, suppose if you want to insert the new node after the node whose data value is 4. It means that you want to insert the node at the specified position. So according to the query, according to the question, we want to find out the node whose data value is 4. So first of all, we have to do the traversing. We have to start with the very first node whose address is 120. We have to visit 2. 2 is equal to 4? No. Then again, we have to go in a forward direction. There is an address 230. We have to visit 230 node. And again, we have to see the data field. Is it the 4? Yes, it is true. The data value is 4 and we required 4. So after that particular node, we want to insert the new node. If you want to insert a new node, you have to create one particular node having some date address, suppose 1000. Suppose the data value is 5, you have to store the data value in newly created node. After that, we have to change the addresses. So the node which is having the data value 4, whose address is changed to 1000, and the data value of a node whose address is 340, which is stored in the next node or the link field of a newly created node. That means 340 is given to the newly created node and 1000 is stored in place of the previous node whose data value is 4. These are the three different cases of insertion. Similarly, we can have a deletion operation. Again, under the deletion operation, we are having three cases. The very first case, delete the first node. So if you are going to delete the first node, so your head will consisting the address of the link field which is stored at the very first node. That means 230 will be stored in the head node. In the second case, if you want to delete the last node, if you want to delete the last node, you have to traverse the linked list. You will see where the last node which is pointing to the address of the very first node. So you want to delete that node. So you have to delete that particular node. So the previous node will be consisting the address 340. So instead of 340, we are going to store the address 120. It means that the last node is deleted and you are having only two nodes in your linked list. After that, the very third case is you want to delete a specified node. Suppose the question is, if you want to delete a node whose data value is 4. So we are going to find out the node whose data value is 4. First of all, we have to do the traversing. You have to start with the very first node, data value is 2. We want to know, we require the 4 value. Then again, we have to visit 230, the data value is 4, we got the node. So we got the node whose data value is 4, we are going to delete this node. If you want to delete this particular node, so address of the previous node whose data value is 2 is going to be changed. Now the address of 120 node is the link field of the address of the node which is having the data value 2 will be changed to 340, and that 340, the node whose address is 340, whose link field will be consist of the address of very first node, that is 120. So this one is the third case of the deletion. Similarly, we can sort the data of a linked list. Similarly, we can merge the two different circular linked lists. So these are the certain types of operation which will be performed on the linked list. The very next type of linked list is doubly linked list. There are again certain problems with a single circular linked list. So what is that problem? In single circular linked list, if you traverse in a forward direction, suppose if you have visited the node 120, then 230, then 340. But in between, if you want to visit the node which is just previous or prior to that particular node. Suppose if currently I am on the position at a node whose data value is 230, that means the node which is having the data value 4, I am here. Suppose at that current position I want to visit a previous node whose data value is 2. So in case of a single circular linked list, it is not been possible to recover such a drawback. The concept of doubly linked list is invented. Now, what do you mean by doubly linked list? In case of a single linked list or in case of a single circular linked list, the node is divided into two parts. The very first part contains the data and the second part contains the address of the next node. But if you are creating the node structure in this way, we cannot traverse the linked list in between. That means if you want to visit the previous node, it not been possible. For that, the doubly linked list concept is invoked. So in doubly linked list, the node structure which is divided into three parts. The middle part contains the data element. The very first part contains the address of the previous node, and the last part contains the address of the next node. So middle is having the data, previous link will be hold the address of the previous node, and the next link will be hold the address of the next immediate node. With the help of this linked list, we can traverse in both the direction at anywhere. We can go in a forward direction or we can go in a previous direction. It means that it is our choice, we have to go ahead or we have to go a back. So at any instance of time, at any instance of a period, we can go in a forward direction or go in a backward direction. So this is the doubly linked list. Again, there are different operations like insertion, deletion operations we are going to perform with the doubly linked list. Again, there are three cases of the insertion and three cases of the deletion.